Today we're going to be learning another stitch in Romanian point lace. We're going to be learning this stitch here. This is a fagoting stitch. It's a fagoting stitch that has an increase in it. It's increasing on the inside of this arc here, and this is the outside arc. There'll be more stitches in each one of these than there will be out here. That way when you get to the center point, you're vertical and you can decrease as you go around and fill in the space smoothly. To do this, you need to have your thread set up in the very corner of your embroidery, which is right here. And a fagoting stitch is a stitch that has a loop in it. I'm just setting up my stitch right in the needle, in the corner right now. I have a few pins up here that are snagging my thread. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to one of the loops on the cord on the outside. I don't know if you can see my needle here. And you're going to go into that loop holding the thread above your work. Bring your needle up. The thread is now behind the work. And you pull the thread. I have a really long thread here because this will take a lot of thread to fill it. Then you go to the other curve here, the other arc on the cord, and you grab the very first loop on the side of it. And you do the same thing. Now this time you're going to grab the next one on this, the next little pico loop that is on the Romanian cord. Same stitch again, but this time when we go back to the inside arc, we're going to go into the exact same stitch as we did the first time. The reason you're doing that is that this arc here has about three times less as many loops to go through as the outside arc. So we're going to go back to the outside one. I got my needle in the wrong spot. Okay, so you go back to the outside one, fill it, and come back to that same first loop again. And you're going to continue in this pattern going around it. This time I'm going back to the outside loop again. So that's the very same stitch both times. When you come to the inside arc, it's above. When you come to the outside arc, it's above. This time I'm going to go to the next loop. I'm going to work a few here, just going back and forth so you can see how this is done, using the same one as I did the last time. Once again, the same as I did last time. And it's always a new loop when I'm on this side that I'm going through. I'm going to go to a new loop on the inside now. I'm going to keep embroidering this until I have it all done during this video. So there might be a point in time where I'm not talking and I'm just stitching so that you can see the finished piece. I have little threads on the side of my fabric that keep snagging. So if you're wondering what those little threads are that keep coming in, I didn't do a zigzag stitch on the end edge of my fabric, and I should have. What you keep seeing me pull down is my loop, because it has to, when you do the stitch, the loop has to go here and your needle is below, and so part of the thread is below the needle and part of the thread is above it, and you need to go in between to make this little loop that happens right here. We are getting near the center point at this part of our embroidery, and you need to pay attention, because when you get to the center point here, you need to be on the center point here. So you follow this line up if you are following this pattern, and when you get there, that should also line up here. So you have to do your increases at this point so that you will come out in the correct position at the center point. So at this time you might be doing two increases, three increases, And when you get to the very center, you might just be doing one stitch there in the middle and no increase at all. So here I'm at the center, almost at the center point. There are two stitches here that are almost at the center, so I'm gonna count them both as center, and there's about two stitches here that are center. So these are gonna go 1 to 1. And better fingers today, sorry for that. Now that we have made it to the center point, I'm going to have to start increasing again. I know it sounds weird because think you're going smaller, but there's still more loops on this side of the arch than here. So there will be an increase that is happening. Going into the same loop as I did the last time. Sorry, started to do my stitch backwards. Sometimes that happens when you're working with the camera there, and I did do it backwards again. Let me undo that one. For some reason my mind wasn't thinking. There we go, this is what I want. Okay, so that stitch, I'm gonna go back to this one again. You notice, I just realized I made a mistake here twice in a row when I said my mind wasn't thinking. So, even if you're used to doing something, mistakes happen. Just undo them. And it might require undoing your thread needle to do it faster. The unstitching part, that is. Okay. For some reason I reversed that I was going in from the bottom up and started switching to the top down, which does put an extra loop on the twist of the fagoting. Now if you want that look, that's fine, but I don't want it switching halfway through my work, so I needed to fix that. Once again, I'm better fingers. Going to the next loop. Same loop as last time. Still, same loop as last time. Next loop. I do recommend zigzagging the edges, but I was in a hurry when I did this so I could get working on the tutorials. New loop. I'm going to go the same way as I did last time. Thing about working with such long thread is it does like to tangle on itself, so if your thread is doing that, just be aware it does it. New loop. From here on out, I will probably always be going to a new loop. This is going through my loop. Did I? No, I had it right. Okay. New loop on this side. Okay, now here in the end, there really is no loop to go through. So what you're going to need to do is just take your last stitch in the very corner of this, pull it the opposite way and tight. That snugs everything down. And the next stitch I'll be teaching in the next tutorial is this one right here. So I'm going to pass my needle inside the cord. And pass it through the loop, and it's now set up for the next tutorial.